Hi everyone, welcome to NetGate Chemistry. So far we have covered 12 previous year questions of aromaticity and we are going to cover 4 more questions from aromaticity previous year questions. So whatever we have done so far, that will be enough for you for the part of aromaticity. So I hope this video is also going to be helpful for you. So we'll start with question number 13. For this question, we have been provided with an alkali metal. So we all know that alkali metals provide electron to the system. So what happens? These two electrons go there, giving negative charge here and positive charge here. Remaining part remains as such. After that, what happens? These sodium metals, they provide electrons to the positive site, and then what happens? Negative charge is developed here also. So now we have to see whether this compound is aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic or quasi-aromatic. So we have to count the number of pi electrons or the electrons which are in resonance. So there are 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10 electrons in the resonance following 4 n plus 2 pi electron rule. So this compound is aromatic in nature. In each question we just have to do the basic reaction, and then we have to find out the number of electrons which are taking part in the resonance only. There were some questions previously which we have done in which I have told you about the heteroatom also. If there is double bond present with the heteroatom, then that heteroatom is not going to donate its electron or lone pair to the system. If double or triple bond is not present, so it is going to donate its electrons. Okay, now coming to the question number 14. Here this compound is given to us and super acid is added to it. HOSO2F is your super acid. So what happens here? This oxygen present over here, it goes out along with electron, developing negative charge on it, and this super acid is attached to it. We don't have to go into full detail for this. We just have to understand that this is an acid. This is going to remove this group, okay? In some way or the other, this is going to remove this group. We always know that if we add an acid, what happens? We look for the polarity in the bonds, and this bond is polar, so it will break like this, heterolytic cleavage. This oxygen will go along with its electrons and it gets combined with super acid, and then we get this kind of a structure having positive charge here. So now we have to look that this part is aromatic, non-aromatic, homoaromatic or quasi-aromatic. It is definitely not quasi-aromatic. If you look at this part, this carbon is sp3 hybridized, but the structure is planar here. So what could be the case? Either it cannot be aromatic actually. So what can happen? We can bypass this carbon, and aromaticity could be maintained here. Resonance can be maintained here. So this could be homo aromatic. See, it is not quasi aromatic. It cannot be aromatic. Now we could have homo aromatics compound or anti-aromatic. It is not anti-aromatic, so it is going to be homo-aromatic. It is not a non-aromatic compound. Now question number 15. Here also acid is provided to us. This is a type of Lewis acid. What is this going to do? See, we are going to see for the polarity. Cl is there. Cl will be electronegative in nature. So what happens? It it gets combined with this Lewis acid. So what happens? This Cl goes out along with these two electrons when we add any acid to it. So what happens? Here and here, positive charges are developed. So now we have to look whether the structure is aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic or quasi-aromatic. It is not quasi-aromatic. So what happens? We have to see all the carbons are sp2 hybridized. Structure is planar. We don't have to bypass any carbon. So it is not homoaromatic. So we have to count number of electrons. There are 2 pi electrons, which is supporting 4n plus 2 pi electron rule. According to that, this structure is aromatic. Okay, now for the last question, arrange in correct order of aromaticity. These 3 are given. So there is a term called as annihilation effect. According to annihilation effect, what happens? Whenever we increase the number of cyclic structures, what happens? Aromaticity decreases. So if we are increasing number of rings even in a given benzene structure, what happens? Aromaticity decreases. So this one is having 1, this one is having 2, and this one is having 3 rings. So as the number of rings are going to increase, the aromaticity will be decreasing. So this one will be having most aromatic, then this one, and then third one. So this was based on your annihilation effect. So if you look at all these 4 questions, first question was, when we added sodium metal, what happens? Whenever we add sodium or any alkali metal, it provides electrons to the system. So it has provided 2 electrons to the system, making it 10 electron system and to be aromatic in nature. For question number 14, we added super acid, which removed this group and made this structure like this, which was homoaromatic, because aromaticity was maintained by bypassing 1 sp3 hybridized carbon. For question number 15, we added Lewis acid. So what this did was, it took out these 2 Cl along with these electrons, developing positive charge here and here. So there were 2 pi electrons. The structure was planar. Each carbon was sp2 hybridized. So it was aromatic in nature. For question number 16, we introduced annihilation effect, according to which if we are introducing number of more and more number of rings, so the aromaticity is going to decrease. So this was most aromatic, than this one, and then this one. So this was all about the aromaticity. So with this, aromaticity unit is complete now by my side. So thank you so much for watching, and this was the last video of aromaticity.